recording.
Hey y'all. So, I've been wanting to do a geode side table for ever. Like, since I first saw Miss Colorberry do it, I've wanted to do it. Then Petra's doing some amazing ones, and a few other artists. And I feel like it's time that I do one. So that's what's about to happen. Okay, so I have this masonite board that is on its face because I don't want to make this side sticky in case I decide to reuse it, so I'm going to do it on this side. I got this Tyvek type tape. This one's from DuPont. It's a flashing systems tape. I got it off Amazon. And it feels like a heavy plastic tape, which makes sense about why resin won't stick to it. I'm going to cut off every part that has like stickiness on it because I don't know what that texture will do to my resin. And the backside of this tape looks like straight up tar. So I think this is like a roofer's or like a construction people tape, so sturdy, I'm sure. So I think my geode is going to be basically from here up. It's not going to be like huge table, it's side table size. So I'm going to measure this out. Double check, measure twice, cut once. I'm pretty sure I heard someone say that before. And then it's gonna take 1, 2, 3, 4, about 5 more of these. So I'm just gonna take this and cut it like this and save myself some time and stress cutting strips of tape. Because genius. Also e-science. I have forgotten how many of these I need, so we're gonna play that by ear at this point. I think I said 6 more. Can't remember. If we were on a live feed, I would ask you guys what number I said. But alas, we are not. Usually I would have my lovely assistant, Jeffrey White.
Come again?
I need assisting. I can't remember how much this tape was, but it wasn't like shockingly much, but it wasn't exactly cheap. So I'm really hoping that it does the trick. Okay.
Well, probably the easiest way to do that, I would just take a little bit off.
Put it on it?
Yeah, just line it up. So you're not having to.
I don't know why I'm holding it like it's not sticky, it's not straight.
It's supposed to be straight, but that's why.
I one beat. Congratulations.
So do you overlap it or does this come off? That's pretty thin. Does this come off? No, this stays, right?
Yeah. This is the plastic that the resin doesn't stick to.
Gotcha.
Supposedly. I would do a
do
slight
right
overlap.
Yeah, I was going to say.
You guys, the next best thing to get for this project is a Jeffrey White, because...
What is a Jeffrey White?
It's Vanna White, but Jeffrey.
I'm like, what is it? What? Who and where?
When? So, for this, we're doing a slight overlap. Because we really don't want... the seams, but there's not a whole lot you can do about it. You can just use a tarp, but I want to see how well this Tyvek tape works. Heard a lot about
can
it.
You push your hand. That's, I mean, you'll be able to feel that. You'll be able to can feel it, but I think that'll be good. You want a little overlay so you know there's not going to be any creases.
Mm-hmm. So.
And I just went.
It's on this side. It's only on one side.
Should I do it this way though? So that the white line's on the same side?
Did you order the lights for this?
No, but it's 2 day time.
Almost just do it. Like, you could do a couple coats. Put it down when it's done, put it like this, and just pour it. And then set into it. You have to have it work.
But this is going to be the top. That's good, or do you want more?
No, that's good.
Y'all, I did the right math. Said share with the fam.
Okay.
a little too hard last night, maybe?
It's pumped.
Now we have our base. So now we have to get caulking.
Get to caulking.
Get your caulk on.
Oh,
I need to shape it. What should I use? Okay. So, you get a reference.
That one.
Are you gonna have a hole in the middle? Y'all, we use chalk pens of various colors to get our lines right. Jeff taught me that a long time ago. Use a different color for every new idea you have so that you can keep track of which ones you're following, which ones you like, and which ones you need to rework. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
All right, so I think I'm okay with this part. I'll
think I want to cut in quite that drastic.
Like this.
No. My new shape idea.
Are you pushing down on that?
No.
Well, I guess I'm going to put it up. Oh, wow. What if you came down and came up a little bit and then you kind of like a, I don't know.
Draw down with the blue. So I don't convolute it with the line. I get the shape right because it's got to be a lot of resin. Kind of like a, not a boomerang, but kind of like a bent triangle.
What if you put a cup holder in the hole so that you can put, so it's not just a hole straight to it?
Functional hole.
Yeah. And you can put those lights around it. Put the switch on the bottom of the cup holder. It's just an idea. Just out there.
I don't want it to be too big of a hole because I don't want stuff to fall through it. I think I could roll with this.
Decision made.
Roll with the punches.
Now we get to caulk it. Hang on, I'm scared. Okay. Are you ready? Using GE's 100% silicone, waterproof, clear, mold-free 30-minute setup. Pow, pow, pow.
Closer, but I think you'll be fine. Yeah, the slower you go, the more that's going to come out, so it makes it a little bit wider base, so you can, yeah, there you go. I'm gonna drop this camera so I can get a little lower.
It's okay, because we got resin.
You think I should make it a silver and black, or a silver and silver one, tea style? Should I bait it?
I would do it like mermaid colors.
Been seeing that magenta color and white and gold a lot.
Good job.
Thanks.
Here you go, another one. I think it'll be too heavy if you did a third one.
No, I'm not doing another one.
Just trying to get it right here, and I'm out of caulk. But shouldn't I scrape the sides so that's flat?
For what?
Huh?